Hi, welcome back to my channel. And now I'm going to be talking about, in my opinion, about homosexuality in the Christian world. Since I'm a Christian and I've been doing Christian content right in the past videos. So the last video I made was about my opinion about abortion. I told in my last video that I'm going to be making this. Do I believe that gays or lesbians or part of the LGBTQ will be saved, or like, is being gay a sin? Ganto. I've been reading the Bible and I've been researching about homosexuality because I really wanted to get why some people would say that homosexuality is a sin. So ito yung na come up ko and na interpret ko sa verses and sa mga interpretations din ng iba. Lust has no gender. Being attracted to someone is not a sin, but acting on it is the sin. Whether I'm homosexual or heterosexual, if I lust, I sin. Or if I acted on it. Merely being attracted to someone, kahit ako, I'm attracted to girls, that is not a sin. Ang sin doon, if I lust after her, or if I had sex with her. I want to cite some biblical verses that corresponds or condemns homosexual activity. Hindi ko na aanihin yung mga verses from the Old Testament kasi, yeah, it's also important pero hindi na masyado mag-focus dun. And same lang naman ng idea sa New Testament na verses about homosexual acts. Pero papakita ko na rin yung mga verses about homosexual acts sa Old Testament. Ayan. Sa New Testament, let's start with 1 Corinthians. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9 to 10. Or do you not know that wrongdoers will not inherit the kingdom of God? Do not be deceived, neither the sexually immoral, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor men who have sex with men. Kung makikita nyo, if you will understand word per word, ang kinocondemn dito is yung sexual immorality. And ang kinocondemn dito about sa homosexual acts is men having sex with men. Walang sinasabi na being attracted to men is a sin. Pero having sex with men is the sin. So another one is Romans chapter 1 verse 26 to 27. Because of this, God gave them over to shameful lusts. Even their women exchanged natural sexual relations for unnatural ones. In the same way, the men also abandoned natural relations with women and were inflamed with lust for one another. Men committed shameful acts with other men and received in themselves the due penalty for their error. Ang kinocondemn dito is the lust and the act of sex or intercourse outside the course of marriage. Kaya pinopoint out yung men having sex with men. Kasi in the past, yung time nila, wala pa namang concept of yung identity mo is this or your gender is this. Wala namang concept na ganon. Kaya nila pinapoint out ito kasi they're sure na men only have sex with men just because of lust dati. Men, parang wala na silang choice kundi makipag-sex na lang sa lalaki kasi nalilibugan sila. Ganon yung context sa Bible and sa dati nga. Parang hindi makapaghintay until marriage, so sexual immorality yun. Last verse from the New Testament, 1 Timothy chapter 1 verse 10. For the sexually immoral, for those practicing homosexuality, for slave traders and liars and perjurers, and for whatever else is the contrary for the sound doctrine. So makita nyo, practicing homosexuality. Ah, so being gay, if I practice being gay, so it is a sin. So being gay is a sin. Well, we first need to look at the context and we first need to look at the original translation of this verse, especially that homosexuality. First of all, homosexuality, the term homosexuality wasn't coined or term until the late 1800s. Kung yung homosexuality wasn't termed yet, so ano yung original translation niyan? Ang original translation niyan is men having sex with men. So homosexuality and men having sex with men are synonymous in this term. Ang kinocondemn again here is the sexual immorality, not the being of a person or not the gender of the person. And having the gender wasn't uso noon. Ngayon lang yun umusbong, di ba? Gusto ko lang din i-clarify na yung mga heterosexuals outside of marriage, like premarital sex, it's also a sin. Okay. Actually, I really do believe that like a person who is attracted to the same sex, but lives for God can be a saint. Ako, kunyari, I'm attracted to a girl. And so what? Attracted ka? Okay, so, ano meron? Attracted ka? May ginagawa ka bang masama about it? I live for God. I don't act on it. And I live for God every single day of my life. I put God at the center of my life. And I am living for Christ. I love God more than anyone. I love God more than my family. I love God more than anything in this world. But I am attracted to a girl. If ganun, I really think that I can be a saint someday. Ngayon naman, what about homosexual marriage? Well, sa totoo lang, wala pa akong final say about that. Wala pa talaga. I'm still in the middle of research. I'm still in the middle of asking questions to different people and different backgrounds, like why is homosexual marriage is not allowed, or why should it be allowed? Ganyan. I'm still confused. Ganito yung naisip ko sa heterosexual marriage. Do ano ko lang to, thoughts ko lang to. Naisip ko, bakit pa heterosexual lang yung ano, yung pa pwede? Because that's the natural creation of God, and only women and men can create life. So naisip ko, okay, sex is only for creation. Then other than that, if you had sex not planning to create something, then that is a sin. Yun yung thought ko. So with that premise, homosexual activity cannot be justified talaga. Kasi nga, you know, they can't make a baby. Okay, so if ganun, what if that homosexual couple promised to be celibate? Ibig sabihin, no sex at all. Like, they just want to live with each other. They're just gonna be celibate. Tinanong ko yun sa iba, tapos sabi nila, bakit pa mag-marriage? Eh, pwede namang outside of the marriage na lang yun. Ay, yeah, huh? Oo, ganun. Parang ako, what if ganun nga? Wala pa akong sagot about that. Wala pa talaga. Kasi if yung kinocondemn lang pala is yung homosexual activity. So like, what if celibate nga sila? Boom. Hindi ko alam. Ito naman din, nagulat ako, 'di ba, yun yung premise ko, like heterosexual couples can only have sex if they create life. Pero the church pala, the church and the Bible, I think sa Romans ata, nabasa ko ata 'yan. Pero ayun, but basta the church allows married couple to have sex outside the creation of life. So like, kasi daw nadideepen yung relationship and your love through sex. So like, eh, bakit hindi pwede yung ano? Yung mga homosexuals. I can't. Kasi sinasabi din naman ng iba din na in the first place, never na-mention yung homosexual marriage sa Bible at all. Pero syempre, wala pa namang concept ng ganun dati. So, di naman. I don't know. Oh my gosh. I don't know. I still don't have the answer for that. I still don't have the answer for homosexual marriage. Wala ba talaga? Like, pero ako, I agree naman. I mean, okay lang sa akin ng yung civil union. Kasi right naman yun ng tao. And kung ayaw naman talaga nila maniwala sa Diyos, kahit anong, ano mo, anong preach mo sa kanila ng gospel, ganun. Kung ayaw talaga nila maniwala, and they want to have that union with their partners. I think civil union is okay. I think civil union is okay. But mind this that it's not in the Bible. So I'm not sure if okay lang kay God. Di ko talaga sure. But okay, I'm not homophobic. Let me clarify that. I'm not homophobic. Arang gusto ko lang talaga yan. Gusto ko lang malaman ng mga bagay-bagay. Yeah, so if you have any questions, if you have any arguments, or if you please help me, please PM me, or please comment down your arguments, whether you're a pro-homosexual marriage or anti-homosexual marriage, please, I just want to see some sides and arguments. Like, I'm still lost. Wala pa ka lang. But again, yet again, being something is not a sin. The gender is not the sin, but the action of lust or the action of sex. Yun yung pinaka-importante that ngayon sa video na to. Pero sa homosexual marriage, di ko pa talaga alam. Help me, that's all. Yun lang gusto ko sabihin. Oof, goodbye. Yun lang talaga. Gusto ko lang i-share din. Bye-bye.